Hi guys, my name is Haika.
My name is Nabiha binti Sunil.
Hi guys, my name is Nisa Yusuf.
My name is Siti Sena binti Mama Yusuf.
My name is Nur Auna binti Mama Zaini.
My name is Nur Shera binti Lun.
And today we will talk about
workplace ethics
and professional ethics.
Assalamualaikum to my lecturer, Madam Izzati and my fellow friends. My name is Muhammad Akash Shafiq bin Muhammad and I will be the first presenter. Today, our chosen topic is workplace ethics and professional ethics. For the next presenter after me is based on the list name arranged. Before I start, I have a short video to show for you. Okay, let's watch.
Ada, kan di paman awak ada seorang nama Hanis. Buang je.
Kenapa? Dia kerja okay, ma. Dia seorang yang sangat bertanggungjawab.
Okay, sini ada satu file. Suruh dia settlekan sebelum balik.
Okay. Hanis, kau cakap settlekan file ni sebelum balik. Tak apa lah, saya tolong awak settlekan sekarang.
Bos, kerja ni dah siap.
Awak rasa awak punya kerja ni betul tak? Panggil Hara datang sini. Saya tengok sini empat baris, ada tiga baris salamnya. Ada apa nak terangkan?
Bukan bos, ini bukan saya yang buat, Heda yang buat.
Kan, kerja tak betul, kita boleh ajar. Tapi hati tak betul, kita tidak boleh ubah.
From the video, I want to ask all of you, can you differentiate between ethical workers and unethical workers? Absolutely, I can say all of you can answer the question because of certain reason you pick and the reasonable idea to choose the answer. Okay, so let's go to the introduction. What is ethics? Ethics is a belief system of moral value, code, or principles. Ethics is concerned of the what is good and often defined as a moral principle for individual and society. This ethics actually can influence people's daily life, like the way of the communication, make a right decision, build a responsibility, and give insight about what to do in future. In simple way, work ethics is a belief system of moral advantage, inner skill, hard work, and dedication to improve character and abilities of individual. Work ethics is also a collection of ideas based on the meanings of work and represent as a willingness or desire to work hard. Work ethics also can avert human beings from committing a crime by their own. Work ethics also seen as a virtue that enhance the characteristic of the individual. Some research has shown that three words may summarize the work ethic, which is interpersonal skill, being dependable, and initiative. So what is interpersonal skills? Before this, we have learned what is interpersonal skills. Interpersonal skills is the habit or action that we use with other people. Interpersonal skill learning starts from early age and affected by the many things like parents, family, friends, observation of the world, or television or movie. To develop interpersonal skill, we must set a quotient around us from outside the perspective who contact us. There are some good skills inside interpersonal skills, which is loyalty, trustworthiness, and self-discipline and self-responsible. Loyalty. Loyalty means that the workers always need to refer to the boss if any problems occur. The other elements of the loyalty is keep the business in a secret or strategic inside the company. You should appreciate your current work and what you have done to the company. If you can't feel pride and loyal to your current job, you need to find other job. Trustworthiness. Trustworthiness means that the employer need to able put employee in a position of trust. If the employer trusts an employee, the employer will ask to do something outside the call of duty and expected that employee can do that things. For illustration, if the boss trusts the workers will be the last person who will keep all the teams in the company in a good condition. Self-discipline and self-responsibility. A part of the taking responsibility for your own action is to be self-disciplined. You are the superior of yourself to manage all the time, talents, and achievement. Self-discipline allows you to structure your time and strength and ability to exploit it. Besides, self-discipline allows you to manage your emotion. Being dependable. Depend is one of highly ethics for workers nowadays. Dependables also includes of the honest, reliability, and punctual. Dependable workers can solve the task perfectly under the agreed of the supervisor. The result, you will develop your reputation for being trustworthy and reliable if you can clear the task perfectly and on the time. Initiative. Initiative is the desire of worker to take the first step to solve or to discover the given task. Procrastination and missed opportunity will be the real issues without initiative. The impact is caused the bad performance result and the workers will not get a second chance and lead to job loss. The difference of average workers and highly performance workers is hard working, soft skills and attitude. With initiative, they will complete the task per the instruction received and show the willingness to assist others. Next is the other's positive of work ethics, which is honesty, respect others, openness, cooperative, and competency. Honesty or integrity is a very significant code in work ethics. As a worker, you need to be honest about your accomplishment or mistake. You only can take a credit from your own work and do not steal others' work or ideas. Respect others is important for workers. This code is more on to take care of others' feelings, no matter how you are in urgent situation or facing deadline submission for your job. You need to show your grace under the pressure and remain diplomatic. For openness, this code is about sharing your opinions, results, and resource with other team members. By the process, your member will know your progress and how you are doing. Cooperative is about how you manage the issues together and find the ultimate resolution. Sometimes, work alone is unsatisfied and unenjoyable. Competence is always needed for workers in order to improve your performance and learn a new skill. Next, continue with next presenter. Thank you.
Hi and Assalamualaikum to everyone. I'm Nisa. I would like to continue this presentation, which is I will present the workplace ethic. My presentation will be highlighted the definitions of workplace ethic, the differences between workplace ethic and professional ethics, the importance of workplace ethics, and the ways to educate workplace ethics. Definition of workplace ethic. Workplace ethics refer to the way that workers in an organization, however, may refer to the ethics or lack of them which permit a workplace. How an organization performs as well as its rival view also depends on workplace ethics. Actually, a fundamentally ethical role should use to model ethical conduct from above and from inside. Workplace ethics embody how business deal with their vendors and clients, they collaborate with others, conduct their activities, and they connect internally and externally. This concept includes almost all problems occurring in a sector, including the manufacture, delivery, promotion, selling, and use of the provided products and services. The differences between workplace ethics and professional ethics. Ethics of the workplace refers to the ethics in which a person deals with the individual and circumstance in daily life. But professional ethics refers to the ethics that a person must respect in his professional life about his or her relationships and business dealings. Workplace and professional ethics in some cases collide and trigger a moral dispute. For example, teachers are entrusted with the role of providing a quality education to all students in the classroom. As a part of ethics, they cannot exhibit racism towards any particular student or even show discrimination against any of them. They should interact with the pupils in an appropriate manner without taking any advantage. They must keep minimum contact with students outside the school premise, and if need arises, it must be related to some school event or function. Second, a police officer may think a law he wants to follow is wrong personally. But under the police code of ethics, however, he must follow all legal and fair orders to uphold the law before adequate justification has proved to do otherwise. So, it may be hard to recognize the distinctions and parallels between workplace ethics and professional ethics. Some people characterize workplace ethics as a structure code, which means that a person can be torn between contrasting ethical values by this concept. Others describe ethics as moral guidelines in general and state that a single moral code is applied in various contexts, including workplace ethics and professional ethics. Importance of workplace ethics. First, workplace ethics provide emotional security, which is, this is the most important workplace ethics. For example, in a company, the importance of workplace ethics where the employees can go to work knowing other workers will not harass them, their supervisor will respect both of them and their work, and their co-workers will reap disciplinary measures if they steal supplies or equipment or falsify company records. Perhaps, supervised staff will eventually hear from failures and develop professional practices, or the organization will reject them. Such disciplinary practice promote an upmarket work climate. Besides, workplace ethics also promotes cooperation and teamwork. Organizations generally discover a difference in the ideals their workers choose to adopt and the behavior. The last one is how to educate workplace ethics. Okay, how will supervisors help to develop a more moral atmosphere in the workplace? The best way is to be a role model and be visible. Actually, no one is saying that you aren't allowed to have a bad day now and then. If you can exhibit a strength, calm and perseverance even during stressful times and good times, a positive attitude overall, you will instill the same within your employees. A positive teammate will be better able to troubleshoot problems and overcome adversity in the workplace. Take care to always lead by example responsibility, and your employees will follow suit. A good leader actually motivates his teammate rather than critiques them and strive to inspire team members to reach their full potential. And remember, leadership role models doesn't come too late overnight. That's all from me. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum. Hi, my name is Nur Auna binti Muhammad Zaini. I am from ED2498B. Okay, now I will talk about professional ethics. The meaning behind professional ethics is a branch of philosophy dealing with values pertaining to human conduct, concerning the rightness and wrongness of actions, and the goodness or badness of the motives and ends of such actions. Now, let's move to the next slide. Now I will talk about top 10 professional work ethics. First one is attendance. Be at work every day. Plan your absence. For example, when you are having an MC or family vacation, let your boss know. Don't abuse leave time. Be punctual every day. Be punctual every day is very important for me because it will show your own character or your own attitude. Next is character. Be honest, be dependable, be loyal, be willing to learn. I guess all of this is very easy to cope with, but for the last one, be willing to learn is something hard because each of us has our own ego. So we choose to hear ourselves instead of others. Next is teamwork. Be a team player, leadership's abilities, be a contributing member and accept compromise from each other. Then next is for the fourth point is appearance. Make sure you wear or dress appropriately. Personal hygiene, wear perfume, invest your money on it, and have a good manners, which is polite towards each other. Next slide, yes.
For the fifth point is attitude. Means have a good attitude and accept responsibility for one's work. Have a good attitude. You need to have that because it will show your inner side of character. And next is productivity. Must stay on task. Whenever your boss or any workmates ask you to submit your work on, for example, on 6 p.m., you must submit it before or on time on 6 p.m. Manage time and personal things properly. Don't mix up anything personal related to work. Put your personal things at home and just focus on your work when you are working. Next is organizational skill. Make an effort to improve, which is be willing to learn with each other and get along with co-workers. Be comfortable with each other because they will surround you like every day and help out whenever asked. When someone asks you for a help regarding to your work parts, help them because when you help people, you will gain more. Let's move to the next slide, which is the 8th point is communication. There are 2 points here, which is written communication and verbal communication. For written communication, for example, when you are write on a report, and for verbal communication, a face-to-face communication within each other. And the 9th point is cooperation. Follow company rules and politics. Do not make your own rules whenever you are working with others. Respect each other. Get along with co-workers, be comfortable and enjoy the moment within each other, and appreciate privilege and do not abuse them. Do not abuse them means don't be sarcastic towards each other. Be nice towards each other. The last point is respect, which is work hard so that you will gain what you want in your life. Carry out orders, do your work properly, and show respect. Show respect means, for me, if you want to gain respect from people, you must show your respect first. That's all from me. Let's move to the next presenter.
I would like to continue the next presentation, which is about professional accountability. Did you know what is professional accountability? Okay, first thing first, accountability means the obligation to perform the duties assigned in accordance with laws and regulations. While for professional accountability is the responsibility of an employee to the tasks that have been entrusted by the employer in an organization. So, moreover, this professional accountability is important in ensuring that the tasks performed achieve the set objective. Okay, next slide. There are few tips for professional accountability in the workplace that you can take note. So, first is have a clear and achievable goal. This means that we need to know the priorities and what objective our company want to achieve so that we can easily complete the work. Okay, and the second is take responsibility and do not make excuses. Okay, if we want to be highly accountable people in the workplace, we must willingly take on a responsibility without making excuses and actively manage it until it gets done. And the third one is on time. Highly accountable people in the workplace will always submit their work or project on time. So the fourth is collaborate. Highly responsible people in the workplace will use the resources around them by collaborate with other employees. Moreover, collaborate among employees in workplace also provide a greater creative input to achieve goal in company. The second last one, manage expectation and do not expect praise or anything in return. When in the workplace, we need to work hard and sincerely without expecting anything in return, such as promotion or salary. This is because of when we expecting too much on praise or anything, we will be disappointed if we do not get that praise or promotion. Indirectly, it can cause us low of motivation to do the next job or project. And the last one is seek feedback and reflect. So everyone makes mistakes. We need to always seek feedback from others and improve it immediately. Okay, next is example for professional accountability when being a teacher. So first is accountability towards students. For achieving optimal learning of students, the teacher should be accountable and should take care of the student's progress according to his or her ability. And the second one is accountability towards society. The most important role of teacher is to bring the students into educational fold, coordinate various activities of the society, and motivate the weaker sections of the society to learn because he or she can develop confidence to link between the school and the society. Hence, the teacher should be accountable towards the society, which is beyond the classroom teaching. And the third one is accountability towards profession. Professionally accountable teachers adopt various methods and techniques of teaching, follow the code of conduct, set the examples for others, and always apply new ideas in classroom situations to help students during teaching and learning. And for the last is accountability towards lifelong teaching and learning. A teacher should devote his whole life to teaching as well as learning for the future of humanity, as his or her role is multidimensional and multifarious. Okay, last is importance of professional accountability in workplace. So there will be several effects if lack of professional accountability in the workplace, which is first low morale, which effective communications in the workplace will lead to low morale. And the second one is low level of trust. Trust is lost when employees are not responsible in completing the work as promised. And the third one is increasing level of stress. This may occur due to unclear priorities and objectives or goal among employees. And next is ineffective execution. If you don't clear with objective or goal to achieve in workplace, it is very difficult to complete the work quickly. And the last one is high turnover. Okay, this may occur when there is a lack of accountability and unclear expectation while doing work or job. Okay, before we go to the next presenter, let's watch this video. When there is a problem in workplace, we keep point out and expect others employees who will solve that problem. Instead, we can be responsible solving that problem by our own self as employees in that company. And in a nutshell, everyone should hold themselves accountable even if they do not feel it is their responsibility to perform a particular task in workplace. So if no one does, nobody will.
Hi, it's me, Nabiha. Next, we go to the integrity. The definition of integrity. Integrity is the quality of having strong ethical principles that are followed at all times. Honesty and trust are central to integrity, as is consistency. What is integrity? Integrity is needed in workplace. It is a key to success in a company or an organization. A person with integrity will demonstrate sound moral and does the right thing no matter who is watching. Wherever they go, they will always do the right thing. Integrity also is the foundation on which co-workers build relationships and trust, and it is one of the fundamental values that employers seek in the employees that they hire. The person with integrity will have high moral values of self-aware, accountable, responsible, and truthful, and that their actions are internally consistent. People who have all of these values will work their job right and honestly.
How does integrity work? People who demonstrate integrity draw others to them because they are trustworthy and dependable. As employees, they are principled and you can count on them to behave honorably. In the workplace, employees that act with the integrity will always tell the truth and accountable and reliable, and treat coworkers, stakeholders, and customers with respect. They will do the right thing even when no one is watching.
Examples of integrity in workplace. First, honesty. Honesty is a key characteristic of a business because it sets the tone for the kind of work culture you want to create, provides consistency in workplace behavior, and builds loyalty and trust in customers and prospects. Second is responsibility. Ethical responsibility is the ability to recognize, interpret, and act upon multiple principles and values according to the standards within a given field and or context. It refers to the obligation each person to do the right thing. And the last example of integrity in workplace is accountability. Accountability is the readiness and preparedness to give an explanation or justification to stakeholders for one's judgments, intentions, and actions. It is about answering for your actions and decisions and accepting responsibility for mistakes. How can you encourage integrity in your workplace? First, clearly outline what integrity means in your workplace. Let our team know exactly what we expect from them in terms of honesty and transparency. We can create a series of ethical standards for the employees. Second, we can encourage an open and transparent environment where team members feel they can freely discuss issues without punishment, so they will be honest and take responsibility of what they had done in the future. Third, set regular integrity self-assessments. In these assessments, employees will have to provide feedback on how they view their actions in the past few weeks or months. They will use as tools for self-reflections, forcing employees to reflect on and consider the way in which they conduct themselves at work. Fourth, as the leader, leading by example is a key. We should practice every action that we preach. Always be honest and true to our employees and step in when we see the potential for dishonest behavior. Fifth, take actions when a staff member acts in contravention to our outline of integrity. We must not let our employees do the same mistakes ever again. Give them a punishment or warning for what they had done. 6. Compliance with current laws, including modern awards, is crucial to running a business with integrity. Give award for those who work their job honestly. This will encourage our employees and colleagues to work with integrity. Why is it important? Remember this. Integrity is an essential trait that employers highly value. It promotes a professional culture in which individuals can depend on one another and treat each other with respect. As a result, people are typically more productive and motivated at work. So, integrity in workplace We'll have dedicated employers, satisfied customers, and solid profit margin.
Okay, issues of integrity in Malaysian's local authorities. From the previous slide, my friends Nabiha already explained what is integrity. There are some issues in integrity that happen in our country, which is in Malaysia. So from the article that I have read, according to Pon and Othman 2010, in the case of 15-year-old teenagers being shot dead for not stopping his car after the police instructed him to do so. So here we can see that the police is not being honest in doing their job, because the police is the one who instructed the 15-year-old teenager for not stopping his car. Okay, next is Malaysia is also not spared in dealing with scandals involving huge national companies such as Transmine, Purwaja Steel, Bumiputra Malaysia Finance, and the Port Klang Free Zone, Pon and Othman 2010. So this is also from the article that I have read. So this is related to the corruptions. Okay, one of the main contributors toward the decline of integrity level among public servants is actually corruptions. Malaysia is no stranger from fraud cases and financial scandals. So, from the table here, we can see, this is the table I got from the article that I have read. The number of arrested civil servants from 2013 until 2015. Okay. From the year 2013, the number of arrested civil servants is 170, 2014 is 225, and 2015 is 398. So we can see from the table here is every year the number of arrested civil servants is increasing, which is regarding the issues of corruptions. These two examples reflect on the public servants' integrity that causes the loss of public trust in government. So next is I want to discuss regarding the issues of integrity that happen in schools, in universities, or other learning institutions, which is academic dishonesty. What is academic dishonesty? Academic dishonesty is also known as academic misconduct or academic fraud, which is referred to various actions of the part of students that go against the expected norms of a school, university, or other learning institutions. So there are some examples of academic dishonesty, which is number one is plagiarism. Plagiarism is representing another person's work as your own work. Okay, number two is cheating in exam, in tests, or in quizzes, which is the student is copying another student test or homework. So another example is academic misconduct, which is obtaining a copy of test before the test is administered. So this is the sum of academic dishonesty that always happen in schools, university, or other learning institutions. Next is ways to help students developing integrity as a teacher. We as a prospective teacher also need to know how to help students or ways to help students developing integrity. Number one is infuse integrity into classroom culture. Teacher make integrity as a norm in their classroom. Teacher may including some aspect of moral value so that the students can see and understand the value of integrity, for examples. The second one is develop a moral vocabulary. According to ICAI, International Center Academic Integrity, there are 5 fundamental values in academic integrity, which are responsibility, respect, fairness, trustworthy, and honesty. So by including these 5 fundamental values in the curriculum, it will help the student develop integrity. So as a teacher may include these 5 fundamental values in discussing some topic of historical topic and also current issues. Number 3 is respond appropriately when cheating happens. When the student cheating in exams, tests, or quizzes, as a teacher, we should respond or talk nicely to the students. Give them some advice that cheating in exam is never acceptable in classroom. Try to give them some time to reflect on their behavior. Last but not least, help students believe in themselves. How teacher can help the student believe in themselves? Maybe teacher can sharing their passion in teaching, why they are teaching, the obstacle, the challenges in order to become a teacher, and how they overcome the challenges and show the students that success is possible, which means success can be achieved by effort and never give up if you want to achieve something. When students learn to believe in themselves, it will help the student developing the value of integrity in themselves.
There are many values of ethics that are important and need to have inside of each human being. Actually, works or professional ethics are not only for worker but need to be trained at an early age of a person, as the adaptation can make some positive change throughout their life. Ethics is not only build people's strength and minimize their weakness, but brings positive vibes and harmony around them and make them more civilized people. Albert Schweitzer said, "The first step in evolution of ethics is a sense of solidarity with other human beings." That's all from us. Thank you.